All right, this is the next in my series of Schumann PLL demos. So we've got today, we've got a Fender 65 reissue reverb twin. It's set on way too low of a volume for it really to be sounding amazing, but my wife's home and she would kill me if I started getting way too loud. For guitar, we'll be using my Jazzmaster, Lee Rinaldo. We're gonna move in here for the kill. Now, first glance, the PLL is a little intimidating. It looks like it has a whole mess load of knobs on it. But really, the basic functions are quite simple, and it's just in the tweaking of those basic functions that things get really hairy. So, as the very first point of action, we will give us some sound. These three knobs over here, this one, and this one, are the three functions of the PLL. Square wave is a fuzz, and you can shape that fuzz through this knob right here, which is the wave shape. Additionally, this is a master volume. So what you have with these three knobs is a mixer situation, where you're mixing in square wave, multiplied signal, or divided signal. Okay. So tweaking the multiplier or the divider starts to come in play with the big knobs here. This is the multiplier and this is the divider. There's some phase settings for those two as well. The pre and gain is something you set up for your instrument, which affects how well the unit tracks as a whole. The trigger, in my experience so far, seems to act mostly as a gate. What we're going to do here is we're going to start out very simply. We're going to leave the multiplier and the divider off. We're going to mix in a percentage of the square wave, and we'll just listen to that at first. Notice it's quiet. So that's just our standard fuzz from the PLL. As we turn this shape knob, you can see where we're getting kind of a more trebly, less original content kind of fuzz. I'm going to bring in just the multiplier, okay? Bringing in just the multiplier. Notice the multiplier is currently set at octave one. And to contrast that with some notey stuff here. That's the multiplier, and it's kind of one octave setting. This is where these three knobs really come into play, as well as this loop speed switch. You can change the responsiveness of the multiplier, so this will sound pretty crazy comparatively. You can change the lag time, which is how long it takes for the kind of kick in. As you play with this response knob, you get more laser beam sounds out of it. You turn it down, you get a little more. More just kind of a resonant sound. The loop track itself gets pretty hairy. We have a kind of high, which seems to be, I'm going to say, the strongest loop tracking. If you turn it down, it's actually marked vibrato right there. and it's like it's tracking and losing the loop a lot. Play that at the same speed here. So you're seeing where it get really crazy with this loop tracking and playing with the loop time. I'm going to turn the loop tracking back up. So here, looking at how the multiplier affects the sound, you can hear the laser beam in the background is about the same. Up to 2 octaves. And it's just getting higher. So that's the multiplier. The divider on. We're currently set at the same octave. And then the notey part. If we move it up. Less response. Where the pedal really gets interesting is when you start combining these things. So we turn on the square wave, which is the fuzz, we turn on the multiplier, we turn on the divider, and then we can of course season to taste. Say that's too crazy for you, because you don't want the multiplier being that wild. So there's all levels of craziness or not craziness. Your basic instruction on the Schumann PLL.